Speaker, sir, I stand to oppose the bill. I stand to oppose the bill, sir, and I feel that this is the third historic mistake which our country is committing. The first mistake was committed in 53 by arresting Sheikh Saab, 87 by rigging the elections, and 2019. Definitely, BJP has lived up to its electoral promise in their manifesto, but you have not lived up to your constitutional duties. You have indulged in breach of a constitutional promise, sir. I must congratulate the Home Minister for the pyrrhic victory in eviscerating Article 370, sir. Sir, I am aware that many of the ruling party believe in alchemy, not in science. But transmuting a state into Union Territory would make Gogai Pasha and Mandrake, the Sarkaria Commission, the Administrative Reforms Commission, and the Rajmannar Commission. I congratulate you. You have definitely taken a dishonorable step of in creation of an authoritarian state, a unitary authoritarian state, sir. Had this issue been done by a governor of a non-BJP, the BJP would have raised how governor is partial to the ruling party. But now when the governor is working on the diktats of the government, the BJP is quiet, sir. Sir, you have ruled on Article 35 and a challenge is presently pending in Supreme Court. And I trust that the constitutional bench of Supreme Court will take up this gauntlet thrown by this government. I want to know from the government, sir, are you planning to implant people as the Israelis? Are you trying to imitate the Chinese? Or are you trying to create a Bantu stance as in apartheid South Africa? Sir, the Honorable Home Minister says it was a temporary provision. Sir, I cannot use the flowery language of Manish Tiwari and talk about an erotic thriller. But I will definitely say that I hope that the Honorable Home Minister will read erudite judgment of Justice Nariman in SBI versus Santosh Gupta, Supreme Court judgment in SBI Zafarullah, which these two Supreme Court judgments have more wisdom than the Honorable Home Minister. And in that judgment, the Supreme Court said, Mr. Honorable Minister, that the Article 370 is not temporary, it is a special status. Sir, BJP has picked up this tactic from the Nazi manual. What is it called in Nazis? It's called tactic of legality. To subvert constitutional principles and values, sir. Sir, the Jammu Kashmir people from last 90 years have been fighting for democratic rights. I want to know from the Honorable Minister, we have used military in Northeast. Why? Because the Northeast people said we are fighting for our dignity. We have used military force. But despite that, this government, despite the Nagas not laying down arms, you are still talking with them. Why? And the Nagas are saying, give us oil and gas. You are ready for that? This will have a grave implication on the solving of the Naga problem. And I want to know from the Honorable Home Minister, sir, he assumes to be a man with iron fist. But may I remind him that the first iron man in the whole democratic or undemocratic world was called Bismarck, the Iron Chancellor. Even Bismarck said that the iron fist must be used by a velvet. And the velvet was Article 370, which you have made it a hollow. And that is why I have to say, sir, that this government has proved that you are neophytes when it comes to statecraft. You have refused to understand where myth ends and where history begins. And I'm forced to say, sir, I'm forced to say, sir, that the English proverb, for they sow the wind and they shall reap the whirlwind. Sir, I want to know when Asaduddin Owaisi can go and buy agriculture property in Himachal Pradesh. I want to know when Asaduddin Owaisi can go to Arunachal Pradesh and Lakshadweep without a permit. I am sure, despite my opposition to all these constitutional arrangements, because I believe more in plurality and diversity, you are going to hand over all these Northeast to the corporate world because you believe in all these issues, sir. Sir, I want to end by talking about how, you know, demographic change. What is there, sir? NRC, CAB? Why don't you release all those Kashmiris? Sir, your MPs are saying this is Diwali. Why can't you leave the whole Kashmiri people? Let them come out. Let them also celebrate. They cannot even use a cell phone. They cannot even go out. What are you talking about? You have created Srinagar as some sort of a West Bank. That is unfortunate, sir. That is why I demand that the government release all prisoners, really, you know, take away the curfew and ensure that communications are started. Last point, sir. What will happen on Eid? Eid is on Monday. Are you assuming that the Kashmiris should, instead of sacrificing lamb, they should sacrifice themselves? If you want that, I'm sure they'll do that. They have been doing that. And I conclude, sir, I conclude by what an erudite scholar wrote today in an article. He said BJP thinks that it is going to Indianize Kashmir, but instead what we will see is potential Kashmirization of India. You are doing a great disservice. Sir, there will be issues in between Dogras and Punjabis in Jammu. There will be issues with Dalits also. There will be, and you mark my words, sir, there will be demand from Hindus of Jammu. Sir, I'm concluding. Please, sir. There will be demand from Hindus of Jammu that why do we live in those two, Pir Panjal and Chenab Valley with Muslims. There will be migration, you mark my words, from Muslims of Kargil. You are under